Good afternoon, everyone. So thank you for choosing my session. Maybe you can compare Facebook session and this session. And so my session, DRONEBIRDs are go. That means, yes, that is a...
Five.
This one.
Four.
Yeah.
Three. Two. One.
Yes. That is traditional SF movie, and that is a very impression. I made similar presentation. Actually, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, DRONEBIRDs ago. Yes, and so today we would like to share our experience and our idea for crisis mapping. Our project name is DRONEBIRD. And I want to show first our movie.
So
many times we join to the crisis mapping with a hot team and other humanitarian works. And this is a
Philippine 2013
big typhoon attack. And after that,
We made some plans based on using the data.
So, and
3D printer.
So sometimes we have to
optimize drones.
So if we
3D printer
can make
laser
so
very small one, so Japanese government can stop.
So we can make very small
drones.
And also, after that, we should make map data using the original aerial photo data.
So, we can connect drone
community to mapping
community.
That is important.
DRONEBIRD
基地. And so, you know, DRONEBIRD has a very good base. And I'm working at the university, and those educational organizations can provide this place like this.
So that we can teach how to make, how to make map data.
So that base is very important. And this is a local area in Japan. So that is a Izu-Oshima Island. That is a Tokyo Prefecture. And there is a big volcano. And sometimes that volcano erupts. And after that, we can do like this.
So local people can fly with drone.
This is the actual drone situation taken by the drone imagery.
Mapping 専門部隊
and also the data can share on the net. So we can copy and we can duplicate the data to the many servers. And of course, before sharing, we have to make also rectify the imagery data. And so maybe you know, many class mappers actually can join to the mapping manager or other useful
workers
to do. And so those data can provide to the local people. Using by the smartphone or all of guys, all these people who want to use paper. So license is very important. So you can copy and you can duplicate as an actual paper map. Or younger people can use data on the bike. So in Japan, we have a lot of natural disasters, but maybe around the Japan, so Asian country has same problem. So we can share our experience and we can share our data and technology. Thank you so much. Thank you so much. And this is our concept movie. And my major work is a teacher. I'm teaching about how to make map data at the university. And so another side, I'm working at the open geospatial community. Post-4G community, OpenStreetMap community, and crisis mappers community. And my account name is Map Concierge. if you can find this face, so please send us a message or something. And in Japan, so we have a lot of open map mappa, volunteer mappa like this. This is the center of Tokyo, and this area has about over the maybe 5,000 open map volunteer mappa. And we are guessing, and we can imagine. So maybe 2 years ago, 2 years after 2 years or 3 years, around 2020, so maybe many mappa will get on drone. And if some natural disaster, like the earthquake or something, so they can use own drone. Around, I think, using by the multi-copter types, maybe those drones can detect in about 500 meters or about 1 kilometer. Very small area, but we can merge, we can make the mosaic area photo like this. And also, we can combine the fixed type of drone like this. So those drones can cover more huge area. I think about 10 kilometers and 10 kilometers. So we can use both types of drones, multi-copter type and fixed type of drones. So this is our process about the DRONEBIRD project. If big earthquake happened or a natural hazard happened, so immediately we use the own drone and we will detect aerial photo. And after that, we can make also rectified imagery as a also mosaic data using by open drone map. Then we can share via open aerial map, that is a data sharing tool. So we can upload and we can provide also rectified typed imagery via open aerial map. That is a whole global community. And we should copy, we should duplicate for another community. That is a whole Japanese community. The name is Jikukan Joho Center in Japanese. And managed by the Tokyo University members and other geospatial organizations. So we can provide our aerial photo data to local government in Japanese or other domestic members. And also engineer labs, GitHub. So we will update our data into our repository on GitHub. Anyway, so those data can provide mappers community. So they can make map data based on our fresh aerial photo data. And end user is many times we can communicate to that Red Cross or MSF or UN or something. And our goal, we hope after earthquake, just 2 hours, we want to share our aerial photo. This is our goal. So in this month, so in Japan has many natural disasters. That is a recent situation. So very serious area is west side. We have, this is Japan, and west side is like this. And July 6th night, so heavy rain attacked the west side of Japan, like this. So the area is very huge area. And there are many flood, landslide, and sometimes houses broken or something. So we are supporting to that each area for the crisis mapping. And this is a very serious area in Aoyama prefecture, like this. This is a big, huge flood situation. The local name is Mabicho, Mabitown, like this. So immediately we contact to the local people. And so this is a flood area on the map. like this. And half of the agriculture's area and half of the city. So this is our member photo in Mabicho. So like this. And then I think just one day, so we uploaded, we made a tasking manager's project like this. And already, so we completed this area for the class mapping. And local people said, so this is the flood area, so the supporting car cannot come to here. And they said, so please make a new map for that navigation. And we want to print out, use it as the paper maps. And we add OpenStreetMap map data, and also we add recommended route. So this area, so the first situation, so many people should go to the north side, and they have to turn left, and they have to over via the mountain area. So this route is the first supporting navigation map. And also, so we take a lot of photo using by mapillary, and we share, and we understand that recent situation. And also that our drone bird team bring their own drone, and they detect and they made also rectified imagery. But yeah, little problem. So many people can use only the multi-copter type. So if we can, we could use a fixed type of drone, maybe we could detect more huge area. But this is recent our power. So anyway, so we made our fresh aerial photo data for that mapping. And another works, before this disaster, so we made a new toilet like this. So, and this toilet is very so clean and so funny. And I'm thinking, and we talking, maybe this toilet can bring our drone. And that drone, the toilet can become our drone bird base. And actually, so this toilet exists in that another local area, and they bring to that flood affected area like this, and they set, and local people could use. And also, we shared recent temporary toilet map data using by crisis map data like this. And we shared there is a new toilet map, toilet at here, this. And yesterday, we shared more useful semantic map system on the net. Yes. So, now we have some tasking manager project on the top. And so this time, our team could communicate to local volunteer community and Red Cross, MSF, and where is that high priority area. So we can support for that crisis mapping. And after that, we made tasking manager's project with HOT, and then so many volunteer mappers and our students joined to crisis mapping project. So many thanks for the volunteer mappers in the world, and maybe we will modify and we will make more good working team. And I want to share that last information about what is next steps. So how should we comply with the area law in Japan? So that is problem for the drone activity. So this is the restricted area for drones area. That is red area, red zone. So red zone means central of Tokyo. So we cannot fly before that submission. So many areas. Drone activities stop. So our answer is we are making agreement between local government. So this is our local government, our agreement place area like this. This is a Tokyo area. So already we, last year, 2017, we have six local governments agreement like this. So urban area of Tokyo, not central. And this year, so we extended. Already we have 24 agreement between the local government side. So like this. So this year's the ceremony for that making agreement, and I bring my drone, and so a lot of mayors joined like this. And next we will decide, so we should extend to the center of Tokyo. And yes, here. So we are talking so to the many organization, local government side. And so this is our next steps for that low activity. And also we should collaborate to the useful and friendly community. And now we are talking to the Wii Robotics team and Flying Lab. That is a very famous drone activity for humanitarian works in the world. And already Nepal Flying Lab member come to Japan, and many times we talked, and now we are making a new flying lab, Japan flying lab, with Wii Robotics team. And so another approach in peacetime, so not crisis situation, so we are doing educational approach. So we are making next generation of mappers with Missing Maps project. So MSF and Red Cross team has missing maps in the world. And also in Japan, we are collaborating in the MSF Japan team like this. And so our students joined to the missing maps like this. So this is a peacetime activity. And maybe sometimes disaster happens, we will change. And another one, education for the next generation of drone pilots. So we want to teach about how to make map data and also how to control your drone. And our collaborator is a local tourism associations. So first area is Izu-Oshima Island. So maybe you know. So this is Izu-Oshima Island. There is, yes, volcano. And 2013, so big landslide happened in this island. And we did crisis mapping like this, and we put the paper maps and for the local people, volunteers. Now, so that is situation stopped and finished. And we bring my student to that Izu-Oshima Island like this with drone. And they made that whole tourism video using my own drone. We shared. So this is our student output. Not for mapping. So they are making the tourism movie for Izu-Oshima Island. Just taking 2 days and midnight, my students edited. So mainly, so this movie explains about there are many good geological places, beautiful landscape or something. This is educational order to draw movies. Yes. So we have no time. So our result, okay. So I showed in peacetime, so we can work for the educational situation. And we can make for that tourism activation activity and general use cases. And if disaster happened, we will change to the crisis situation. So we will make the crisis map data, and we will share some useful geospatial data as DRONEBIRD. Thank you so much.
Thank you very much, Taichi. If someone has some questions.
Hi. Hi. What's the investment for such a drone?
Investment?
Yes.
How to say that? That means that.
I mean, can local mapping groups afford such a drone?
Yeah. So in Japan's situation, drone community and mapping community not connected. And so I'm a mapper and also I'm a drone pilot. So, but many drone pilots say, if this happened, our drone technique can support for the local people. But, so actually, they can fly, but they cannot share own data, like the open data say, license or something. So many times, so they work, but their activity is very closed community, and or many times very individual works. So our DRONEBIRD project, we want to connect drone community and mapping community. And also we want to define those data is open data, CC BY or CC BY SA, and traceable for that OpenStreetMap. So that we want to make those situations. And we want to connect the drone community and mapping community in Japan.
Thank you.
Someone has some other question? So.
So I put my DRONEBIRD stickers on the corner of this room. So please get your stickers. Yes.
Thank you very much, Taichi.
Thank you so much.